In this video, we'll talk about chlamydia, which is the most frequently reported bacterial sexually transmitted infection globally, which is caused by the bacterium Chlamydia trachomatae. The good thing about chlamydia is that it is easily curable with antibiotics. Chlamydia can infect the genital tracts, including the cervix, uterus, fallopian tubes, urethra, and in males the epididymis can be affected. It can also infect the eyes, throat, anus, and rectum. Adults who are younger than 25 years old account for the majority of cases of chlamydia. The highest reported rates have been among females aged 15 to 24 years. Chlamydia is especially common in people who live in low-income areas. When assessing the risk factors of chlamydia, usually there is a history of sexual activity without condoms, multiple sexual partners, previous history of STI, concurrent STI, and age younger than 25 years old is a major risk factor for chlamydia. Chlamydia trachomatis is a gram-negative obligate intracellular bacterium. It is primarily transmitted through sexual intercourse. Following transmission, many patients remain asymptomatic and half of the patients will spontaneously clear the infection. Chlamydia trachomatis attacks columnar epithelial cells, such as those present at the squamous-columnar junction of the cervix, where they initiate local inflammatory response. They infiltrate host cells and resist lysosomal degradation. They then reorganize into reticulate bodies and replicate to infect more cells. Many people with chlamydia have no symptoms. If symptoms occur, they usually appear 2 to 3 weeks after infection, which is usually the incubation period for chlamydia. But it can take as long as 6 weeks. Symptoms in women include unusual vaginal odor, vaginal discharge, dyspareunia or pain during vaginal intercourse, bleeding between menstrual periods, postcoital pervaginal bleeding, proctitis, which is the inflammation of the lining of the rectum in cases of receptive anal intercourse, rectal discharge, lower abdominal pain, fever, and nausea may occur if the infection spreads to the uterus and fallopian tubes. Symptoms of chlamydia infection in males include yellow or white watery or urethral milky discharge, urethral itching, a painful burning sensation during urination, swelling of the scrotum and testicular pain, proctitis or inflammation of the lining of the rectum in cases of receptive anal intercourse, and rectal discharge. In infants, chlamydia can cause pneumonia that presents with cough and fever. And it can also cause conjunctivitis, also known as pink eye, and usually presents with eye swelling and eye discharge. To screen for chlamydia, endocervical, urethral, rectal, or oropharyngeal samples should be taken and tested for Chlamydia trachomatis bacteria. There are two primary methods of testing for chlamydia: nucleic acid amplification tests and cell cultures. Nucleic acid amplification test is the main diagnostic test for chlamydia. It is more sensitive than cultures and result in more diagnosis. Cell cultures are best used when there is blood or mucus in the collected samples, as this usually interferes with the accuracy of nucleic acid amplification test. People who have chlamydia should be checked for gonorrhea as well, because there are high rates of this infection in people who have chlamydia. Chlamydia is curable. It can be cured with antibiotics. The recommended treatment regimen is either a single dose of azithromycin or a 7-day treatment regimen of doxycycline. Since reinfection with chlamydia is common, all people with chlamydia are advised to be retested 6 months after treatment has been completed. In women, chlamydia infection of the cervix, if left untreated, can progress to the uterus and fallopian tubes, causing pelvic inflammatory disease, chronic abdominal pain, infertility, and an increased risk of ectopic pregnancy can all result from this. Epididymitis, which is the inflammation of the epididymis, can lead to infertility in men. Untreated chlamydia infection of the rectum can cause proctitis, an inflammation of the rectum lining that can become chronic. Untreated conjunctivitis caused by chlamydia can cause scarring of the cornea. And that is all for this video. If this video has been helpful, give it a like, share it, and hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. Until next time.